special significance for Ayodhya and thousands and lakhs of devotees worldwide as it marks the first celebration of Lord Ram's birth at the newly inaugurated Ram Mandir. And what a sight to watch, to see the rays of the sun kissing and touching the forehead of Lord Ram. This is an unreal moment, in fact, a celestial moment, and scientists ensuring that this is done with utmost grandeur. In fact, the Ram Mandir in Ayodhya is set for the Surya Tilak. Everyone who is gathered there today in Ayodhya had been waiting for this very, very precious moment. Just take a look at how the rays of the sun falling exactly at the forehead of Ram Mandir. A lot of work has been done to ensure that this is done with utmost precision and grandeur. The pandits doing the aarti, 25 lakh devotees have gathered for this celestial event. It is absolutely fascinating. This is the first time Ram Navami is happening since the consecration of the Ram idol. The sun rays falling on the forehead of Ram Lalla in Ayodhya. And what a moment, especially for those lakhs of devotees who have gathered to watch this once-in-a-lifetime event. It's absolutely beautiful. We are getting to see the rays of the sun falling on the forehead of Ram Lalla. This is called the Surya Tilak of the deity. It has been made possible with really elaborate techniques and mechanisms. It involves mirrors and lenses. So everything has been done to ensure that this is possible with utmost precision. And we just were witness to this absolutely awe-inspiring spectacle when the rays of the sun touch the forehead of Ram Lalla. I think it's done now, and we are still seeing a little dot, if I'm not mistaken. We can still see the dot of the sun on the forehead of Ram Lalla. Devotees across the world, in fact, are celebrating Ram Navami today, the birth of Lord Ram, one of the most revered deities in Hinduism. And as we speak, as we're getting you these live images, we just got to witness that beautiful moment when the rays of the sun fell on the forehead of Ram Lalla. And as I just mentioned, this is a scientific way of ensuring that the rays of the sun actually falls on the forehead of Lord Ram. Just take a look at the visuals there, and lakhs of devotees who have gathered to witness this absolutely awe-inspiring moment, spectacle. Siddhant, my colleague, is one of the lucky ones today in Ayodhya. And Siddhant, the highlight of today's celebrations is undoubtedly the Surya Tilak. What a breathtaking sight to see the rays of the sun falling on the forehead of Lord Ram.
That's right. And in fact, you know, Ram Navami holds a lot of significance for Ram Bhakts. In fact, there is also this ritual of Saryu Snan. So, aisa kaha jata hai ki Ram Navami ke din Prayag bhi utke Saryu mein aa jata hai. So, there is a lot of belief as far as Saryu Snan is concerned on the occasion of Ram Navami. And this is a reason that each time, with each, every year, you know, lakhs of devotees come to Ayodhya to take a holy dip in river Saryu. But this time around, the major attraction is also to seek darshan of Ram Temple. Now, right now, I am at Ram Temple, and behind me, you can see the corridor. This is the same corridor which will take me inside the Ram Temple, and we have been told that that the rituals have commenced inside the temple. So 11:58 is the Muhurat time, and we have been told that at around 12:16 the Surya Tilak of Bhagwan Shri Ram will commence.
Siddhant, so that has happened. I presume that you're outside the temple. You know, we are seeing the visuals of that spectacular sight of how the rays of the sun fell on the forehead of Ram Lalla. Let's talk about the significance of Ram Lalla's Surya Tilak. In fact, I believe that this has been done with a lot of thought, a lot of precision. Indian scientists, in fact, were involved, and they have ensured to make it possible through mirrors and lenses for the rays of the sunlight to fall on the forehead of Ram Lalla. Dushyant Sridhar, in fact, Vedic scholar, is joining us on the broadcast. Mr. Dushyant, thanks so much for speaking to us. What a beautiful sight. You know, as I speak, I'm seeing that the images of the rays of the light delicately kissing the forehead of Ram Lalla, an absolutely awe-inspiring spectacle, breathtaking to say the least. How was this done? I believe that there was a lot of planning to ensure that the rays of the sunlight actually hits the forehead of Ram Lalla with utmost precision.
Yeah, namaskaram to all the viewers.
And happy Ram Navami to you as well.
Oh, thanks so much, and wishing you too, and wishing all the viewers a very happy Ram Navami. See, Bharat Desham, our country, has always tied its spirituality with science. So science, astronomy is not new to this Desham, and most of our ancient temples are constructed so beautifully, coinciding with solstices, equinoxes, where the rays of the sun would directly fall on the devata, the deity, the murti within the Garbha Graham of temples. And just not here, even temples of Hinduism constructed outside Bharat Desham, like even Angkor Wat in Cambodia, has been aligned with the Surya's inclination. That said, see, Rama comes in the Vamsha of Surya. He comes in the lineage of Surya, Ikshvaku. So he says, I come Vivaswan, Manavebraha, Manur Ikshvakum Abravit. I come in the lineage of Vivaswan, whose son. And second thing is, Rama interned under Vishwamitra. Vishwamitra was the rishi who gave us the Gayatri Mantra. Gayatri Mantra recited towards Surya Devata. Mm-hmm. And Surya, in a way, is invincible. We can't even think of approaching the sun. Even in an increase of 0.5 degrees Celsius will cause so much of havoc. So Surya is invincible, so is Rama. And Rama's Ayodhya itself means a city which can never be impregnated. It is so very strong and invincible. So many connections that we establish. And with respect to the science here, we have, I'm sure the scientists have guided so well, and so are the artisans, who have taken so very good care of putting mirrors in different places so that the rays of the sun get reflected in multiple places and finally falls into the lalatam, the mastakam of Rama, and that enlightens the entire Garbhagriham and the temple. And that's the way I presume and I feel that, Sanatana Dharma can gain its ground, because, you know, this Dharma, Sanatana Dharma, Hinduism, has for a very long time so beautifully married itself to science.
Yes.
Be it the medical science called Ayurveda, be it the astronomy, the astrology, be it the sciences that we all revere, like chemistry and physics and mathematics especially,
yes,
have been profoundly given to us in various forms, in various scriptures, through Aryabhatta, Bhaskara, and even great rishis. So this is the way forward, where you can always make an astika of Sanatana Dharma feel. See, here is science and here is spirituality, and both of them marry and make friends so beautifully.
And
that
coexist
is
so beautifully, and we are seeing that. But how beautiful the sight is, Dushyant. I'm just seeing those visuals of, the sunlight falling right at the middle of Lord Ram Lalla's murti. It is absolutely a spectacular sight, so meticulously planned, designed, implemented to achieve utmost accuracy. I wanted to understand the significance of Surya Tilak also, and what really it means for the people who worship Lord Ram, and the significance of Ram Navami today, Dushyant. What does it really mean for those lakhs of devotees who have gathered in Ayodhya today? For the first time, we are celebrating Ram Navami in a place where Lord Ram has a home for himself, his own place, a place that has been yearned for years by his loved ones across the whole of India.
Very true. So Valmiki Maharishi in the Ramayana states, Tatascha Dvadashe Maase Chaitre Navamiketi Thau Nakshatre Aditi Deivatye Swachcha Samsteshu Panchasu Graheshu Karkate Lagne Vakpata Indunasaha, he states. So on the Tithi of Nami, which is the day today, in the asterism, in the star of Punarvasu, which has been aspected by a devata called Aditi, and on the Shukla Paksham, the waxing phase of the moon, was born a boy whose astronomical details, he states, where five grahas were in the exalted state, and in one house was Vakpata Vindunasaha, where Chandra, whose moon, and Brihaspati, Jupiter, are together. So our rishis have gone to the extent of giving the date, the tithi, the asterism, the astronomical, the astrological details when Rama was born. And Rama's path that he took, the sojourn, the journey that he took across the country to delineate the ideals and the dharma, is called Ramayanam. So Rama and Ramayanam are inseparable and Ramayanam and Ayodhya is inseparable. So this temple which celebrates Ramanavami after a huge hiatus of over 500 years in the very same Rama Janmabhoomi temple is a big achievement to the civilization and the civilizational ethos. That yes. said, talking about the Surya Tilakam, see, Surya, even the basic of fundamentals that we know, when we go to a doctor, he always asks us to get our vitamin D checked. So vitamin D is extremely important, and the biggest source of vitamin D is the sun. Mm. And our ancestors and rishis have said in the morning, in the afternoon and the evening, you have to look at the sun and offer argyam through water. So we have always believed that the rays of the sun do cause give us long life and good health. So the very presence of sun is so important to each one of the communities in Bharatadesham. That said, Rama comes in the lineage of the sun, and a sun is called Pratyaksha Paramatma. See, when we have to think about the Lord, the one whom we see day in and day out is the sun. And we believe within the sun there is a lotus. Dheyas Sada Savitra Mandala Madhyavarti Narayana Sarasijasana Sannivishtaha says the Puranam. It says that there is a lotus within the sun, and within the sun, seated in the lotus is Narayana. So Narayana's avatara, the incarnation, the manifestation of Narayana's Rama. And today we see the rays of the sun touching Rama, which is a beautiful circle going about.
Yes.
So that's another thing. And last of all, see, we do in the modern days of 21st century, we have LED lights, this and that. But can anything match the glow and the radiance of the sun? Nothing can even get closer to the sun. So the sun's rays can illuminate the entire world. And here is the Lord telling that I am the sun, I am the moon. Chandra Surya Ucha Netre Karnavashaha is the shlokam in Vishnu Sahasranamam. One eye of Rama is the sun and one eye of Rama is the moon. Mm. So that is why the sun's rays are touching Rama, and Rama is called Ramachandra. So you see both Surya on his forehead and his face looking like the full moon, like Chandra, depicting the beautiful conglomeration and the fulcrum of astronomical and astrological details that we see together.
Oh, how lovely. Absolutely, Dushyant, you put that so well. And speaking of Surya Devta, he is also one of the most revered deities in Hinduism, not just because the Surya or the sun is a powerhouse of energy, but also its ability to sustain life on earth and its healing powers as well. You put it so beautifully, the ability of Hinduism to go along with science. I remember the Supreme Court had also described Hinduism not as a religion, but as a way of life, how it goes beyond idol worship or other worship rituals and, the sacred to include an exploration of the cause of natural events as opposed to accepting them as it is. And that, Dushyant, is science in itself, isn't it?
It is very true, because we are a very pluralistic religion. We do have multiple, we have respect towards every creation. Though we see the same Almighty or Paramatma or Bhagavan whom we call in everything, we respect every creation of the Lord. Mm. Be it the sun, the moon, the stars, the earth, the five elements that we know as Panchabhuta, so on and so forth. And something very interesting is, your viewers will surely appreciate, we have this Tropic of Cancer that runs through Bharatadesham. Above and below the Tropic of Cancer is where you have a very severe flow of the sun's rays. And that's why we call it the Shaura belt in Sanatana Dharma. Shaura means Surya. So Surya Devata's worship is there, right from Bihar to Uttar Pradesh to parts of Jharkhand. We have parts of Madhya Pradesh, upper parts of Odisha, Maharashtra, then the lower parts of Kashmir, where we have Martanda Surya Temple, Punjab, Rajasthan, Gujarat, and Pakistan and Afghanistan. So this is called the Shaura belt. And there was an Uzbek traveler called Al-Biruni of the 10th and 11th century who, in his sojourn to the then Bharatadesham, records that he saw a beautiful Surya temple by the banks of river in a place called Multan, which is called Moolasthanam in Pakistan. And he says in that temple he saw the Devata, the Murti of Surya Devata, floating in mid-air because of the magnetic forces. He also talks about the ruby-like eyes of the Devata. Mm. And then the region in Gujarat where they extremely celebrate Surya is called Shaurashtra. And that Shaura means Surya. And a section of the Saurashtra people to escape the invasion came to the south of India, and till date they are called Saurashtris. And something interesting is, even in the musical form of India, we have a raga that invokes Surya called Saurashtram. And so all these things, even when you go outside India, Amitika, if you go to Cambodia, where we have this temple called the Angkor Wat, constructed in the 12th and 13th century. Mm-hmm. It was constructed after the planetarium was constructed, and it is believed on the day of the solstice, the rays of the sun exactly fall on the Vishnu Devata there. Mm-hmm. And the king who constructed was called Surya Varman. So the Surya, sun, everything is so very linked in Sanatana Dharma, and our almanac, which we call as the Panchangam, is based on sun and the moon. So we have the Chandramanam and Shauramanam. Mm-hmm. So that's why we always base it on either the Tithi, which is Rama Navami or Krishna Janmashtami, or we base it on the Nakshatra. So we also take the asterism, the star, into picture. So today is a wonderful day for all the Astikas, just not in Bharata Desham. See, there are devotees of Rama and the diaspora across the world.
Yes.
So he's not just central. We may be thinking he's Indian. He's global. So he's east, west, north and south. So he's there everywhere. So I remember during one of my lectures in Indonesia, the person who drove me in the car, he was a Muslim, a very devout Muslim. His name was Aditya. Mm-hmm. So the importance of Rama, the importance of Aditya, the importance of Surya is found just not in Bharata Desham, across the world. And Sanatana Dharma plays an important role in spreading this wonderful universal message of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. We are just one family.
Yes. Oh, absolutely. Dushyant, it was such a pleasure speaking to you. And thank you really for enlightening me and our viewers as well on the significance of the Surya Tilak, the visuals that you're watching on the right-hand side of your screens. What a spectacular event it was. In fact, the highlight of the celebrations has been the Surya Tilak. It's the first time that one is getting to see the sun rays delicately gracing the forehead of Ram Lalla in Ayodhya. And speaking of Ayodhya, I'm going to go straight across now to my colleague Siddhant. He's in fact been there since the morning. Siddhant, I was just talking to Mr. Dushyant about this celestial moment, this breathtaking sight. And I'm sure that Ayodhya has been abuzz with preparations for Ram Navami celebrations. This is the first time that people are actually coming and, you know, paying their respects to Ram Lalla in the temple themselves and not in a tent. How significant is this moment for them? How important it is for their emotions?
Well, look, I'm meeting lot many people, those who are regular to Ayodhya on the occasion of Ram Navami. They come here for holy dip. So each time they used to be in Ayodhya, they used to seek darshan of Ram Lalla in tent. This is for the first time that they are going to get darshan inside Grand Temple for Ram Lalla. And this is the reason that that thousands of people have come to Ayodhya today to witness, to experience this day. In fact, there's a long queue. The police and the administration is making sure that there is no overcrowding around the temple, and this is the reason that in batches the devotees are being allowed to enter the temple premises. We are reporting from inside the temple premises. This is the same route which goes to the temple. In fact, there is decoration also which has been done by the temple trust. The entry gate of the temple has been decorated, and you know, the special arrangements have been made for the devotees today, because as they were coming in large number, so more kiosks to keep the valuables have been arranged, more police protection, the queues have been increased, the VIP darshans have been cancelled by the administration. So lot many things have been done so that the people can get darshan smoothly. And for 4 days, going by numbers that have been thrown to us by the administration, approximately 1 lakh people are going to be in Ayodhya, from 15th to 18th of April. So it's a historic, day for the city of Ayodhya and also for crores of Ram Bhakt across the world. It's an emotional moment. You can see the devotees coming here in Land. Mahaji, kitna bada din hai aaj ka?
बहुत बड़ा दिन है आज,
बहुत बड़ा दिन है। दर्शन करने जा रहे हैं, कितने पैसे लगे लाइन में?
हम तो अभी आए हैं सुबह दर्शन करने।
कहाँ से आ रहे हैं? कहाँ से आ रहे हैं?
उत्तरोला से।
उत्तरोला से तो ये बजाते हुए अंदर
भगवान के बना है तो गाय
हाँ।
तो हम गाय भाप भर लीजिए, हम बनाए।
ओके
आएंगे बाबू राम राजा दशरथ
लाला। See the excitement now, these devotees are being allowed to for the darshan, and they are going inside. They are in rush because they want to go get inside and seek the darshan. So this is how the mood is like here on ground. Lot many of them are waiting on that side. They're waiting for their turn. कहाँ से आए आप लोग?
राम मंदिर से.
राम मंदिर से? राम मंदिर तो ये है.
वहाँ से वापसी आए.
अच्छा वापसी आए तो एक बार दर्शन हो गए. हाँ. तो दोबारा लगे दर्शन के लिए.
हाँ.
अच्छा कैसी भीड़ है?
बहुत ज्यादा है.
बहुत ज्यादा भीड़ है. सूर्य तिलक के वक्त थे आप अंदर?
नहीं थे.
नहीं थे तो अब सूर्य तिलक के बाद दर्शन करने जा रहे हैं. हर साल आते हैं?
हर साल.
हर साल तो इस बार खास है?
बहुत खास है.
बहुत खास है. खुश हैं?
बहुत खुश हैं.
ओके सो देयर आर लॉट मेनी पीपल कमिंग फ्रॉम दैट साइड. इवन पीपल आर बीइंग अलाउड. हाँ जी कहाँ से?
छत्तीसगढ़ से.
छत्तीसगढ़ से. कितने दिन सफर करके आए?
दो दिन सफर करके.
दो दिन सफर करके आज के दिन के लिए?
हाँ आज के दिन के लिए.
तो पहली बार दर्शन कर रहे हैं?
पहली बार दर्शन कर रहे हैं.
पहली बार दर्शन. हाँ. कर रहे हैं. कितना टाइम लग रहा है अंदर?
अंदर 20-25 मिनट.
20-25 मिनट में दर्शन हो रहे हैं. इसलिए दो दो तीन तीन बार किए ले रहे हैं लोग. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन हैज मेड such an arrangement that one can get darshan in 15 to 20 minutes. So that level of arrangements have been made. So you know, people are doing darshan more than one time as they are already here. We'll speak to some more people also. कहाँ से हैं आप?
हम दरियर से.
दरियर से. एक बार दर्शन हो गए?
नहीं अभी आए हैं.
पहली बार आए हैं दर्शन के लिए. स्नान किया सरयू में?
हाँ,
हो गया स्नान. हो गया स्नान के बाद दर्शन के लिए आ रहे हैं.
हाँ,
क्या माहौल है बाकी?
ठीक है.
ठीक चल रहा है. आराम से दर्शन हो रहे हैं?
आराम से.
सर वेयर यू कम फ्रॉम?
I've come from Assam.
Assam. So it's the first time you're getting inside?
Yeah, temple. First time, yeah.
So how is the arrangement? You liking it?
Yeah, it's good.
It's good?
Fine. Yeah, right.
It's fine. It's an good. Auspicious day, historic
yeah,
day.
Yeah, I know.
That's
that.
Why you have planned to come.
Yeah,
to...
we have planned, yeah.
Okay, okay. You've come with the family?
Yeah, with the family.
सर जी हमको है ना इधर बहुत दिक्कत हुई है. 5 किलोमीटर चल के जो आने का है ना वो पूरे इंडिया में ऐसा तीर्थ यात्रा नहीं देखा. योगी जी को बोलो आप चल के आओ तो मालूम पड़ेगा. इलेक्ट्रिक गाड़ी चालू रखो.
ओके ओके. इलेक्ट्रिक गाड़ी चालू कर. पीपल आर फेसिंग सम प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज यू नो द टू अवॉइड ओवर क्राउडिंग अराउंड द टेम्पल. The parking is at a distance from the place where we are reporting from.
Understandable, isn't it, Siddhant? That's understandable. The Ram temple has just opened recently. Yes, there will be teething issues. The security arrangements have been made. In fact, elaborate arrangements have been made to accommodate the expected influx of devotees. But coming to you, Siddhant, I'm so envious of you enjoying the sights and sounds and seeing the people celebrating this moment and celebrating Ram Navami with utmost devotion and fervor. Also tell us, once the people finish their darshan, what happens next? Where do these devotees go? I'm sure there are a lot of shops also out there. If I'm not mistaken, Peda. Yes. The Pedas there are so popular. Have you gotten a chance to try them? Have you eaten something ever since you've gone reporting to Ayodhya?
Yes. Trust me, to be honest with you, I have been eating only since morning. Wherever I'm going, people are offering me pedas, kachoris, samosas. So, you know, that's their love. And even since I was reporting here in January, so most of them have become friends now. So, if they get to know that I'm here, so they already arrange things for me. We'll speak to people. Haan, sir? Kahan se aa rahe?
Vaishali, Bihar.
Vaishali, Bihar. Theek intezam hai?
थोड़ी कमी है.
थोड़ी कमी है.
हाँ, थोड़ी. अच्छा. इतनी कमी नहीं होनी चाहिए.
आप स्नान किया सरयू में?
नहीं नहीं कर पाया.
नहीं कर
नहीं
पाया.
कर पाया.
दर्शन के लिए जा
रहे. दर्शन के लिए जा पा रहे हैं.
परिवार के साथ आए हुए हैं?
यस.
ठीक है. बाकी माहौल ठीक है?
माहौल ठीक है लेकिन व्यवस्था बहुत गड़बड़ है.
व्यवस्था गड़बड़ है. सो सम पीपल आर नॉट हैप्पी बिकॉज पार्किंग इज नॉट नियर टू द टेम्पल. सो दैट इज देयर प्रॉब्लम. सर कहाँ से आ रहे हैं?
हम बांदा से आ रहे हैं.
बांदा से आ रहे हैं. ठीक है. दुरुस्त है मामला?
बढ़िया है.
हैं
जी. बढ़िया.
पहला ऐतिहासिक दिन है जब रामनवमी राम मंदिर बन चुका है और पहली रामनवमी पड़ रही है.
जी जी.
कैसे?
हम इससे पहले आए हैं.
हाँ.
हमने यहाँ देखा कि यहाँ तो राम का नाम लेना मुश्किल पड़ रहा था.
हाँ.
लेकिन अब इतना हम स्वतंत्र है कि जय श्री राम के नारे हो रहे हैं.
हाँ.
और बहुत
सरयू में स्नान किया.
सरयू स्नान हुए सुबह. कल के
स्नान अब उसके बाद दर्शन और फिर जलपान.
जय.
ठीक है एकदम.
जय श्री राम.
जय श्री राम. सो लॉट ऑफ एक्साइटमेंट. मेनी पीपल आर सेइंग दैट द पार्किंग इज फार अवे सो दे आर फेसिंग लॉट ऑफ इश्यूज. बट देन अगेन यू नो पीपल आर हैप्पी ऑल्सो. हाँ सर. जय श्री राम.
जय श्री राम. सर बहुत बढ़िया माहौल है.
बढ़िया माहौल है.
बहुत बढ़िया. रोम रोम.
तो ये पहले राउंड के दर्शन के लिए जा रहे हैं? दूसरे तीसरे राउंड के दर्शन?
ये दूसरा राउंड है हमारा.
कल शाम लोग दूसरे राउंड वाले मिल.
कल शाम राम जी का जन्म हो गया. अब हम जाएंगे.
अब हम जाएंगे सूर्य तिलक के बाद वाले स्पेशल दर्शन.
मैं आपके चैनल के माध्यम से एक बात कहना चाहता हूँ दर्शकों को अब राम जी आ गए हैं, पधार गए हैं, अब इसी के साथ गोहत्या भी बंद होनी चाहिए।
गोहत्या भी बंद होनी चाहिए, ठीक है। अब ये बताइए,
पूरा हिंदू है ना गोहत्या पे जोर लगा रहा है, अब सबसे लास्ट काम जो बचा है गोहत्या बंद हो और सनातन की जीत हो, बस गोहत्या
तुरंत बंद हो। सनातन हाँ, कहाँ से आ रहे सर?
हम तो यही अयोध्या के,
अयोध्या के ही है। पहली बार के दर्शन हो रहे हैं या फिर
दूसरी बार?
दूसरी बार की, और पहली बार हो गया दर्शन, सूर्य तिलक के बाद पहली बार हो गया।
23 तारीख को
देखिए, ये रेड कारपेट डाल रखी है भक्तों के लिए सरकार ने,
बहुत अच्छी व्यवस्था है, पानी बढ़िया व्यवस्था है, पानी
प्याऊ लगे हैं, भंडारे लगे हैं,
भंडारे सब
बढ़िया, इंतजाम बढ़िया है, जलपान का भी अच्छा है, पूजा पाठ का भी बढ़िया इंतजाम है, सरयू भी साफ हो गई है,
बहुत अच्छी
स्थान की व्यवस्था, क्यों माता जी, स्थान की बढ़िया व्यवस्था है,
बहुत अच्छा है,
ठीक है, इंतजाम
सब सफा है, सब चीज
बड़े खुश है आप, पूजा जलपान पानी सब व्यवस्था है, रेड कारपेट देखिए सरकार लगाई है,
बहुत अच्छा है, चलने में बहुत आराम है, चलने में
अयोध्या में और पूरे देश में प्रभु राम के जन्मोत्सव, प्रभु राम के स्वागत का बहुत बड़ा अभियान चल रहा है, बहुत बड़ा उत्सव चल रहा है, हम भी उससे जुड़ना चाहते हैं, भले हम अयोध्या नहीं पहुंच पाए, हम यहां से प्रभु राम के जन्मोत्सव में जुड़ने के लिए अभी कुछ ही पल में वहां पर सूर्य तिलक होने वाला है, आप भी अपना मोबाइल फोन निकाल करके उसकी फ्लैश लाइट चालू करके हम भी प्रभु राम को प्रणाम करें, उस सूर्य तिलक की तरह हम भी अपने मोबाइल का फ्लैश निकाल करके, फ्लैश चालू करके, सब लोग अपने मोबाइल का फ्लैश चालू करें, सब लोग, भले दिखाई नहीं देगा लेकिन आप करें, प्रभु राम को सूर्य तिलक हो रहा है, सब लोग अपने मोबाइल का फ्लैश चालू करें, सब लोग, भले दिखाई नहीं देगा लेकिन आप करें, प्रभु राम को सूर्य तिलक हो रहा है, तब हमारे मोबाइल फोन से भी प्रभु राम को हम प्रणाम कर रहे हैं, हम भी सूर्य तिलक में हमारे मोबाइल के किरण भेज रहे हैं, मेरे साथ बोलिए जय श्री राम, जय श्री राम, जय जय श्री राम।
Well, Siddhant continues to remain with us. He is in-